Microphone 1, 2, 2, 2. Check, 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 check. Hot mic, hot mic. Microphone 1, 2. Microphone 1, 2. Mic 2. Mic check 2, 3. Mic check. Hot mic what? A mic check 1, 2. Yeah. A mic check 1, 2. Yeah. Check. Check. Check 2. Check 3. Mic check. Yeah. Hot mic 1. Hot microphone. Hot. Yeah. A hot microphone. Mic check 1, 2. Hot microphone. Check. Yo. Hot mic check 1. Hot mic check 2. Hot mic check 3. Hot mic check 4. Hot microphone check. Yeah. Yo. Yeah. Hot mic 1, 2. Hot mic check 1. Hot mic check 3. Yeah. Are we hot? We live or we about to go live?
We live.
This is the Veterans Report with your host, Dodge Citizen, broadcasting live from Capitol Heights, Maryland at the eLife Media digital broadcast platform. All right. Long time no see, folks, because I know I was out of the loop and off the air last week due to family matters. Unknown soldier is here on the boards off the camera shot. I'm going to ask you to stand by just for a moment. See what's going on here. Have to respond to an emerging scenario. Okay. All right. Let's get some. Okay. All right. What was I going to say? Again, this is the Veterans Report with your host, Dodge Citizen. Want to get some housekeeping issues or matters out of the way. 240-455-5934 is the studio hotline telephone number if you wish to dial in and be heard or register an opinion or some other kind of input to our broadcast. 240-455-5934, the Veterans Report with your host, Dodge Citizen. You can also reach us online at www.vetsreport.com. That would be Vets Report. Victor, Echo, Tango, Sierra, Romeo, Echo, Papa, Oscar, Romeo, Tango, vetsreport.com. www.vetsreport.com. And if you go to that site, you will see the website that supports this broadcast, and it is filled up with information about the show and about your host and about some of our distinguished guests and even our co-host, Brother Staff Sergeant, medically retired Milton Akers, a twice deployed combat veteran and my dear friend. www.vetsreport.com. If you wish to interface with your host or this broadcast via the Twitter social media platform, that would be Citizen Dodge. One word, Citizen Dodge at Twitter, or at Citizen Dodge, rather, on Twitter. Or if you type in the name Dodge Citizen in the search bar on Twitter, I'm sure Citizen Dodge, or at Citizen Dodge, which is us, will come up. And if you go to that Twitter feed, as I'm going to do right now, and you look at it, you will notice that that Twitter feed is replete with articles and opinions and other trending topics that have resonated with your host, and I have posted. So if you go there right now, you'll see Dodge Citizen, and it gives a description at Citizen Dodge. Medically retired combat leader, U.S. Army officer, veterans advocate, writer, and music producer. And it also states, my service-connected album project is coming soon. And we'll talk a little bit more about that a little bit later. But if you go to the actual feed for Dodge Citizen or Citizen Dodge, you have Veteran of the Day, Mike Dowling. You have Veterans Beating a Silent Killer, which is an article about the 90 veterans clinically battling hepatitis C. And it's a very informative article that states that when it is treated properly, there's a 95% cure rate. Another thing posted today from the New York Times, more United States troops may be needed against ISIS in Syria, a top general says. Also this morning, the next big thing, drones supplying U.S. troops. Very informative and interesting article in the USA Today today. And for me, as a former U.S. Army Transportation and Logistics Officer, this technology, if it becomes actionable and if it is used, will be something that totally and radically changes and contributes to the real-time evolution of the logistics platform as we know it in the Army. And actually, it's happening in the private sector as well with Amazon, UPS. Everybody's in a race to try to implement drone activities in a meaningful way to assist in the logistics supply chain. Also, let me see. Yesterday, this really doesn't have much to do with Veterans Affairs, but if you know me, you know I love Bruce Springsteen. I put up something that was on Apple News about Bruce Springsteen performing somewhere, and he invites a young fan on stage with him. This young man, aspiring guitar player, knew all of the words to one of Bruce Springsteen's songs called Growing Up, and it was just beautiful. So I posted that. Also, VA supports the Great American Spit Out, which encourages veterans to quit smokeless tobacco, which, as we know, contributes to myriad gum and mouth oral-related issues, most notably cancer, okay? And all kinds of corrosive activities going on with the teeth, the sugar, the tobacco. Just not a lot of the chemicals, just, you know. So, VA offering 8 million. Let me see. Wait. Well, I missed that. VA offering up to $8 million in grants for adaptive sports programs that aid disabled veterans. VA research works to improve health equity among a diverse veteran population. Veteran of the Day, Navy veteran Leonard L. Crawford. Veteran of the Day, Army veteran Carl Les Fordahl. Can yoga ease your PTSD? Jim Mattis to Baghdad. We're not in Iraq to seize anybody's oil. Great clarity coming from the Honorable Jim Mattis. At Joint Base San Antonio Randolph, lift 100 tons in a day? Sure, why not? This is about strength conditioning, physical fitness activities, a weightlifting challenge at San Antonio Randolph. Good to see those military members, active duty, retirees, and others participating in strength conditioning related fitness challenges and activities. I put up an image that I really like. May no soldier go unloved. May no soldier walk alone. May no soldier be forgotten. May no soldier be left behind when they return home. I put that up because those words almost perfectly encapsulate what the entire spirit of this program is all about. The Intrepid Fallen Heroes posted three days ago, happy birthday, Coast Guard Reserves. Veteran of the day, 3 days ago, Army veteran Francis Joseph Ryan. Veteran of the day, 4 days ago, Army veteran Terrence A. Brown. Posted 4 days ago a very poignant image that a citizen recorded out of the window of an airplane she was getting out of, commercial airline flight. And everyone on that flight was asked to respectfully forego off, getting off the airplane because that plane was also carrying the body of a fallen Green Beret. And as the passengers sat on the plane, the flag-draped transfer case containing the body of that Green Beret was wheeled off, and his wife and other family members approached, and his wife tearfully reached her hand out and touched the striped casket. And other family members also touched that casket. And in the background, you can hear, I believe it was a Delta flight, but don't quote me. You could hear the person saying, thank you for your patience. And the military wife was hailed as a patriot, a survivor, a hero. So if you go to this site, you can see that video. They said not many people on that airplane were able to exit the plane without having tears in their eyes after witnessing that component of citizenship, the type of citizenship that we don't always see. So, matter of fact, let me say that soldier's name. I'm actually going to open it up. I'm not going to play the video, but actually, I think I will. Let me see if we can. I have it plugged in. I'm going to play this video if I can. You can just kind of hear some of it. See if we can get this thing to play. Lisa Williams, whose flight arrived at the Raleigh-Durham Airport in North Carolina Tuesday, said passengers were asked to stay in their seats so that they could let someone off the aircraft first. Soldiers unloaded a flag-draped coffin from the plane's cargo area, and then T.J. Thomas, the wife of Officer Sean Thomas, stepped off the plane to grieve the loss of her husband. It was an honor to fly home with this patriot. God bless his wife and family. There was not a dry eye around me, Lisa Williams noted on a Facebook post. She said the plane remained silent as passengers started to cry. Seven Green Beret soldiers later loaded the coffin into a black hearse and paid their respects while the pilot thanked passengers for waiting. Thomas, a 35-year-old who had been deployed in Niger to help train local troops and residents in the fight against terrorism, died in a non-combat vehicle crash on February 2nd, according to the Army Times. He had been deployed to Iraq and Afghanistan 7 times and earned 2 Bronze Stars for good conduct medals and was posthumously awarded the Meritorious Service Medal and Army Commendation Medal for his work in Central Africa, the Army Times reported. He was stationed at Fort Bragg. Thomas was buried last week at Arlington National Cemetery in Virginia and is survived by his wife and 4 children. The video had more than 5 million views, and Williams said Thomas reached out to her to thank her for capturing the moment. I'm going to see if I can play this, see what this audio sounds like. I'll tell you what you're seeing. You're looking out of the window right now, and the 4 soldiers now are standing there as the plane's hatch is open, and they are working in tandem to secure the flag-draped transfer case and ease it down the off-ramp from the plane. And they are taking care, as you see the red and white stripes and the stars draped over a brown transfer case or casket. Military has a name for everything. It's a casket to civilians, but we've learned to use the... You can hear people talking in the background. This video is being recorded from inside the airplane, looking out the window. Looks like an official from the airline is there to oversee and to liaison with the military officials to make sure that this is handled with the precision. And then the wife comes up, dressed in all black. She puts her right hand up on the flag-draped coffin, and then her left, and she puts her forehead gently against the casket, clearly in tears. And you can hear the weeping amongst the passengers inside the plane as it is being captured on video. Then another member of the wife's family, perhaps her mother and father, and another person, and they all hug one another and place hands on the casket, supporting the mourning military wife. Very quiet in the background as this is being recorded. The only thing you can hear is the breaths, the sobbing. The wife walks away and the family members walk away. And you can still see the casket with the flag draped over it as it sits on the off ramp. And you can hear breathing in silence. And then the military drill team comes. And you can see them being led, and they stop there in their dress greens, and they come over and secure the casket off of the off-ramp with their white gloves and full military regalia with the utmost of dignity. They secure the casket. Six soldiers, three on each side, and one leading the formation as he salutes the other three, march the casket and load it ever so carefully into a black hearse. This is all being captured in utter silence as a plane full of citizens pay their respects and wait patiently as this most rare but all too frequent of military exercises is conducted. As the drill team marches away, white gloves.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, we appreciate it.
As you can hear, the airline representative thanks the passengers for their patience. Very poignant. I challenge you, I invite you, please come to the Citizen Dodge website, Twitter feed, or Google it online. Military wife mourning fallen Green Beret and viral video is hailed as patriot. And watch that. That should be an exercise in citizenship for everyone. It's the part of combat that we don't often witness, the quiet moments, the sad moments. Moments like that when citizens coalesce and are joined in a moment. And for those moments, are one people, a respectful people, a non-judgmental people, a caring group. Anyway, as I stated, I felt that was truly a very, 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 very soul-churning experience to witness, and my prayers go out to that fallen soldier's family, his wife, the four children that they mentioned. We pray and we hope that God is merciful and beneficent as always, as he shines the light of strength and fortitude into the lives of the survivors of that family, especially those young children. And we ask that Almighty God endows that soldier's battle buddies and friends, mother and wife and brothers and everybody in his life who he touched, and he was a wellspring of strength and fortitude and motivation for. We ask that God bless those people connected to him to continue to be motivated and inspired by him, even as he has transitioned from this life, but still lives within them through his memory and through his human example. Anyway, why don't we, on that note, I'm going to, play a song that's probably appropriate. I think I play this song a little bit too much, but I love it nonetheless. Faces of the Fallen. Song that will be on the upcoming Service Connected album project. Appreciate your patience. Gotta find this thing. Okay, we're looking for it. Again, it's funny, people always tell me I appreciate your patience, and sometimes I say, well, I'm not patient, but since I have to be. So I'm hoping that you are patient as I try to find this. As I said, we'll be looking for interns soon that can assist, production interns. Let's see. Right, let's see if what we can do here. Anyway, this song right here is called Faces of the Fallen. Dedicated to my fallen brothers and sisters in combat.
Couldn't stand back up. Like my man Big Pete, my man D10, my man Boogie, from the combat objectives back on the streets again. I see the faces of the fallen, and it's tearing me apart. Come on, yeah, come on, 1, 2, how we do? I see the faces of the fallen. I read their names every day in the newspaper. So many good lives lost that we can't replace. I keep the call signs that's on the surface of my heart. Tombstones, graveyards, tough love dies hard. I seen the faces of the fallen in my dreams, mommy. I feel them teardrops falling. Hear the voices steadily calling me. Distant echoes down the hallways of my heart. I seen the faces of the fallen, mommy. And it's tearing me apart. I hear them calling. So many faces of the fallen. But come on. Yo, yo, I'm still here, Joe. Since I've been with you, it's with you. Every time my son smiles, I think about your kid. Yo, I remember you and everything that you did. On the battlefield, in the midst of struggle. You led from the front, never lost your humanity. Self-service, personal courage and integrity. Out you run, it's time to wonder who I'll be. Pieces of a man that trying to keep together. Then trying to find smiles to replace the fact. Still trying to reconcile how it all went down. Day I miss you, brother, you know I miss you right now. I dedicate this for you, I hope you hear me calling the bass to the ball, man. Come on, whoever figured it'd be you. Sometimes I wish it was me, so many nights I can't sleep. Swimming through grief, my eyes saw water, bloodshot red. Thinking about which ones died and who got dead. My little homie woke up with a plate in his head. Say I can still feel the pain, but I ain't got no legs. Why they even save me, bro? Should have left me for dead. Now he's dealing with depression, the guilt of survival. Contemplated homicide, even felt suicide. He hears the voices of his homies. He hears his battle buddies calling. That's what he told me. He hears the dreams and faces. Yo, he's trying to fall in. Yo, come on. Bleeding out to a flat line, toe tag, better back.
Flag over the
don't tell me.
I'm gonna pick you that. Dear Lord. Die here, I wanna get up from this puddle of blood and help my peers. I can't feel the pain yet, don't even know I'm hurting. I'm mad at myself cause I don't wanna be a bird. I guess it's lights out, time to go now. My combo reverie, sing a song at my night night, remember me. I see the faces of the fallen and they're calling me. Come on, I'm coming home, mommy. You don't wanna see me like this. They had to keep the cats closed, mommy, no last kiss. I guess I see you on the other side, so keep me in your prayers. No need for despair, mommy, I know you cared. It was my time to make my egress from this life. I only wish I could have said goodbye. Never meant to make you cry, mommy. I know I lived a lonely soldier's life, a high risk. Guns and warfare, bullets with no names. The politicians don't care, they play with words, they play with lies. No care for who dies, so many cruel lies. Cause cash rules everything around us. That's what my journey taught me. That's what I really care about, mommy. It's going down like that, and it just ain't fair. Among the faces of the fallen now, remember me. I say my prayers, mommy. And I remember the combat objective. The bomb city blowing up, sniper fire coming. RPGs and IEDs had us all running. Some guy hit, some made it away from the AK spray. The mortar rounds felt like judgment day. And when that reaper came, some had to go away. I miss my dear friends, Lord, I miss them every day. And I still hear their voices calling, calling in the wind. My homies calling. City, son. It's dedicated to my man Boogie, Big Pete, Deep Dent, and so many others on the combat ejective. On the combat ejective. Original 202 Dodge City, son. Still here where you left me, mommy. My man Big Pete, my man D-Den, my man Boogie, yo, Faces of the Fallen, yo, Again, Faces of the Fallen. Hold on just for 1 second. Okay, I know what that is. Okay. Also wanted to play something that I'm just having some fun here. I found this, I guess, a song I was working on a while ago called Maintain. Just funny the stuff you find. It's called Maintain right here, just a music bed. The hook in here reminded me about how I felt about my chain of command when I got out of the military. I'ma still maintain. They'd rather see me. They'd rather see me fly than to see me fly. You can take it out. Yeah, I think a lot of soldiers feel that way. What was it? I don't know if you heard it, the hook, but it was, they'd rather see me die than to watch me fly. Something, something, something. And put a, they want to, wait. They want to do something to me and put a tear in my eye, but I'm going to still maintain. I'm going to still maintain. That's how I was feeling when I did that. I kind of felt like I was fighting an uphill battle. Wasn't getting much help from the folks that I went to combat for and represented with the uniform on, you know. But anyway, I happened to be going through some old files and data, and that popped up. I forgot that I had produced that track. But at any rate, again, this is Veteran Report with your host, Dodge Citizen. I think we mentioned about 240-455-5934. Hold on, let me see. Hold on. Brother Milton Eggers says he's running into some stuff, so he won't be in today. But I'm texting him, I'm being unprofessional. Letting him know he is here in spirit. Maybe he can call in. What's the number? See if he'll call in. Because Milton Eggers is doing something really cool. Yeah, there was a miscommunication
Yeah, there was a miscommunication with the, with that good brother today, and he's got some stuff going on, and we respect that, because I know I had some stuff last week. I'm going to go back to my Twitter page, which looks like something happened here. I've forgotten 24. So I was just followed today by, what is this? U.S. Army Sergeant, Gulf War Vet, author of Battling the Storm Within, which is a number one Amazon bestseller, inspirational speaker, veterans advocate that empowers others through faith. She has 22,398 followers and looks like she operates out of Michigan, and her website is Battling the Storm Within. Thank you, Miss Stephanie Shannon, for following the Veterans Report with your host, Dodge Citizen. And just at her, on her Twitter page, and she says, save the date, Saturday, March 18, 2017, from 12 to 4 p.m. EmpowerWomenVets.com is where you want to register. And it is Michigan Women Veterans Empowerment, Healing Through Arts. Join us. Let me see what it is. I'm going to go to the Evite. It gives you an Evite link. Join us for Healing Through the Arts, Art Therapy, and Writers Workshop. Food, music, fun, relax and relate and write and create your story in a painting or in a story form for the next Our Voices United Volume 2 book. Open to the public and male and female veterans, registration is required. A donation to the Peace Art Gallery is appreciated at the door. Parking is free. And in the rear of the building, but is limited. And they put in parentheses, busy downtown Detroit area near Tiger Stadium. Swords and Plowshares, Peace Center and Art Gallery, 33 East Adams Street, Detroit. And it has a beautiful graphic, Healing Through the Arts, Art Therapy and Writing Workshop. Master's Level Art Therapist Rosalind O'Nickel, I gather, will be there. This is scheduled for Saturday, 18 March 2017, from 12 noon to 4 p.m. Register online at MIWVEC or Mike India Whiskey Victor Echo Charlie at yahoo.com, or go to www.empowermiwomenvets.com. And again, male and female vets are welcome. And I'm not in Michigan or Detroit, but if I was, I would certainly, if I was in anywhere near that, the location of this event, Miss Sergeant Stephanie Jade Shannon, I would certainly be numbered amongst the participants there on that day. Matter of fact, I'm going to retweet. And I'm going to like this because arts therapy has been quite an effective clinical tool for me as I have fought my journey post-combat and even in combat, because I was writing in combat as well, but it was really identified as a tool clinically for me after my time in the uniform. So, and while I'm on Sergeant Stephanie Shannon's Twitter page, let me just scroll down, and I think she has another post about her book. Okay, reality check. Men are victims of sexual violence too. It's a hard pill to swallow for many people. And then, at military sexual trauma. And Sergeant Stephanie J. Shannon's book is Battling the Storm Within. And let me see if I can read this closer. I have informally diagnosed my toxic leaders as having narcissistic personalities. Narcissistic leaders have an inflated sense of self-importance and an extreme preoccupation with themselves, their success, their career, and their ego. Everything is about them, their center of gravity, everyone around them, and their unit. So, and you can go to her website, www.battlingthestormwithin.com. That's the name of her book. I cannot say I've read it, but I'm sure it is quite the poignant and engaging read. And then she's got a lot of facts about military sexual trauma. 10,800 men are sexually assaulted every year in the military. I never knew that. Versus 8,000 women in the military are. I never ever knew that. There's a high number of male military sexual assault victims. I did hear one time that if a man is assaulted, they are going to be less likely to report it because they don't want the embarrassment and the shame, of being viewed as a victim, that kind of a victim. You know, like it's almost like you're not a man anymore. You know, there's another word I'm looking for. It's can't think of the word, but it's like a stripe. You know, oh, that's that guy that was, you know. Anyway, so I guess this is part of Sergeant Stephanie Shannon. Sure, she may have had some experiences in the military, and it is a focal point of her advocacy, and we salute her. Anyway, so I invite you to go to Dodge Citizen or Citizen Dodge at Citizen Dodge Twitter. What else do we have going on? I happen to be in my inbox. That's what I was wondering why I was here. I was in my inbox. Said I had a bunch of notifications. So, anyway, I invite you to roll through. I have 10,400 tweets. And most of them, I would say 50% of those are resource and knowledge-based tweets. Many of them are pictures and images, but even more of them are articles and things of that nature. Okay. Let me see. Play another song. See if we can find another song here. Right, the great American songwriter Billy Joel. Well,
they're killing me out there. keep cutting this money. Damn, you can hear that all on the
floor. Yeah, I know.
Cameras to shoot the landscape. We passed.
Vegas. Okay. Let me push. Oh, we can go back. We're ready. Are we hot?
Good.
Okay. Bless, 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 bless. This is the Veterans Report with your host, Dodge Citizen. We have a very special veteran who tried to actually call in. Hold on.
So he's going to call back in 5 minutes.
He's going to call back. And we're going to talk to him about some really interesting things that he is undertaking or initiatives. Okay, so again, that's one of my favorite Billy Joel songs. And like I think I mentioned on the show a few weeks ago, funny how, you know, as a writer, I don't know if I want to call myself a professional writer, but I mean, I write songs and I write poems and I write just in general. And I've written for many years. And I don't think I really critically and analytically listened to the majestic, if you will, composition of those words in that song. Just so beautiful. So, I mean, oh my gosh. I've always known how brilliant Billy Joel was, but I don't think I ever listened to that song in the way I did a couple weeks ago when I played it on this program. Just such an awesome artistic treatment of the Vietnam experience. And I'm sure my Vietnam veteran brothers and sisters who hear it can attest to the authenticity, if you will, and the accessibility of the words and the phrasing, the language. The Unknown Soldier here is from that era. Does that song hit you when you hear some of Billy Joel's words in there? Mm-hmm. Almost like that brother was over there, you know? And the best artistic artisans and story writers and singer-songwriters among us, actors as well. I know if you remember Denzel Washington, he played what was that guy? He played a boxer. The guy went to
jail. Hurricane Carr.
Yeah. And Denzel says that what he does is when he's getting ready to play somebody, a lot of actors do this. He'll go and hang out at a gym around boxers, listen to the way they talk, the way the gym smells, what they do when they're in the, everything. Not just when they're in the ring, but everything. And if it's a particular person, I think Will Smith he just played
Ali.
Ali, and he did a great job. But he also played, remember when he played that Nigerian doctor? And about the concussions. Matter of fact, that was the name of the movie. And I have some African friends that say that it wasn't the best Nigerian accent, but to my English ears, it sounded like a really good Nigerian accent. I know some Nigerian friends, but I have some Nigerian friends and some friends that are more interspersed in the African community. They said, it was okay. But for a guy like me, a layperson, man, he knocked that accent out. But my point is, Denzel, he says that he will go around a person, the atmosphere that they grew up, if he can go to that person's home, if he can talk to their mother, their father, he could be around, if it's a boxing thing, if he can hang around other boxers, listen to the language that they use, listen to the language that trainers use. Even Denzel, as we know, even does an exceptional job of picking up like the slight movements. Well, anyway, I'm going off on this big long tangent to say that Billy Joel did his research in a similar way to write that song, and to because he almost sounded like he was a soldier. Like a lot of my songs I write, I can write them the way I do because I was a soldier. You know, I wrote the incident reports. I've been to the funerals. I've seen dead bodies. I've seen grown men cry in front of me. I've had to positively identify a dead soldier, you know, and then watch them. I've seen somebody conduct last rites. I've seen them pull the white cover over the body. You know, I've been down and talked to the what's the name of the person for estate, that who tells you how the person died and all that. I'll never forget that. I had to do that one time down in Richmond, Virginia for a soldier.
The coroner?
Coroner. I've been to the coroner's office. I've had to get the copy of the coroner's report so we could close a case. You know what I mean? I've done the serious incident reports, the 15-6. So if I write a song about military service, the casualties, death, dying, whatever, sadness, the joys of combat, it's because I've experienced it. And I'm an artist. A brother like Billy Joel may not have gone to combat, but he came from that era, as Bruce Springsteen said as well, where most of his friends either deployed or some went, and I remember Bruce says that so poignantly, some went and some didn't come back. And many of those that came back weren't the same anymore. So, anyway, that's a magnificent, brilliant song by Billy Joel, and take my hat off to him, and that's why he is who he is, one of the best that ever did it, you know? I always wonder how people play and sing, you know what I mean? And the piano is different than, I mean, the guitar, it seems like you can, it's a little bit easier, but you still have the two hands going on and the notes and stuff. But with the guitar, I think if you have a band, like, you can just kind of, because I think a lot of really good guitar players, when they go on stage, they have other guitar players that are backing them up. You know what I mean? Like, if they miss a chord, you're not going to notice because they got the other guitar player, the other, and the bass player, electric guitar player. But, yeah. Him, Alicia Keys, Stevie Wonder. You think about all these piano. I'm not a big Elton John fan, but I know he's a bad boy. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Bad boy. Norma Jean. What was that? The song he did about Marilyn Monroe? He did a couple of them, but that one, I'm sure that one right there alone pays for all his expenses. Anyway, Billy Joel. Gotta love it. Want to go back to my Twitter page. I have to tell you, I depend on Twitter, this Twitter page, when I'm online so much, because anything that touches the veteran experience that's in the print or digital media that I see, no matter where I am, I upload it to Twitter. So anything, I upload it to Twitter. And let me just say one other thing with regard to politics. If you know me on this show, I try to stay above the fray. I think I was rather what's the word I'm looking for? Salute? Rather, I got somebody out here. You can't see him, but, well, you might be able to see him a little bit. The man 5-0 Graham with the plan. DJ Flash Drive is in the building. I gotta give him his respect when I see him. Oh, he's coming in. DJ Flash Drive is in the building. I gotta give him some respect. I don't know if the audience can see him or not. If you don't know him, you need to know him. You know what I mean? But anyway, he's off the shot. This is the Unknown Soldier. He was on the show before, but he doesn't, you know, he doesn't want to be seen. So we call him the unknown soldier.
The unknown soldier.
Yeah. Okay. He got some story. He got some soldier stories to tell, but he only lets them go a little bit at a time, if at all. He doesn't want all the press and the cameras and the young ladies knocking on the door and everything. You know, he's a 007 type of guy.
I got you. How you been?
I've been hanging in there by the grace of God, man. Hanging in there. And you're well, brother?
Yeah, I'm just here. I'm back here at work after my wife had surgery. So.
Oh, man, how's she doing?
Oh, please.
Okay, minor surgery? Well, they always say no surgery, yeah.
Surgery ain't minor.
Yeah, correct. She's doing
fine.
Good, God bless.
She told me, she kicked me out the house.
All right, because you were doing too much.
Yeah.
Okay, well, good for you.
She kicked me out the house, said, go to work.
Good for you, brother. How many years you been in the marriage game?
We've been together for 5 years.
Okay.
Now. Yeah, we're going on five.
Okay, so. That's a blessing. I bet you knew her longer than you've been there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we met here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so. At this place?
You know her.
Who?
Sonora. Heavy set girl. Work in the back.
Oh. I don't know if I've seen her before, but I probably have. Yeah, but I probably say hi, ma'am, every day and didn't know.
Then,
okay. Oh, that's a blessing.
Yeah.
She's going to be off work for a while?
Yeah, she ain't. I don't think she's coming back. I'm going to keep her out for another couple weeks.
Good, good. And I know you got that big bread, so you can afford that, you know.
Man, I'm broke than broke. Can I borrow
$20? All the wealthy people say that. That's a good one. I'm going to tell all my listeners. All of the wealthy people, they always got their bread. Well, my pockets is on rabbit ears. You understand?
But I'm going to catch you later.
All right, brother. Show. Peace and blessings.
Yes,
DJ
sir.
Flash Drive in the building. Much respect. Salute, General.
Salute.
Yes, yes. Now I wanted to say something about this political stuff, right? You know, if you listen to this show, what I will say about our president is I didn't respect him having words in his mouth about Senator John McCain, a 7-year prisoner of war and a decorated combat veteran, whether you like his politics or not, whether you like him personally or not. If you never served in combat, never wore the uniform, and when it was your time to serve, you got a deferment for whatever reason, don't talk about a uniformed service member who has served. That's all I'm saying. That's not even politics. I'm just, you know, we had something in the streets where you say, keep my name out of your mouth. And I felt like Donald Trump should have kept Senator McCain's name out of his mouth. And I furthermore, even though he may have thought that Mr. Khan, I think his name is, the brother that passed away, and his parents spoke at the Democratic Convention, Mr. Trump, or President Trump, well, he was candidate Trump at the time, should have refrained from commenting on that soldier's family or that soldier. Anything. Just, you know what, other than to say, I honor the service and sacrifice of that family and that fallen soldier. But, anyway, so you know my point on that. I was not happy with then president candidate Donald Trump's. And I'll further go to say that I felt like he was rather manipulative in his trumpeting of veterans' causes, you know, or his allegiance to veterans and this and that. I'm not going to do this debate. I'm going to do something else and then give the money to veterans' causes and all that stuff. And I personally didn't think, and I still don't think, that any presidential candidate, Hillary Clinton, Donald Trump, Bernie, and George Bush, Obama, none of them love veterans' causes or veterans or are going to spend more money than either of the rest of them. The VA is not going to be better because President Obama's in office or Hillary or Donald Trump or Jeb Bush or anybody. So it's, and it's preposterous for one candidate to say that, that they're going to be more for the veterans or more for the Army or more. However, the veteran community and the active duty military community were strong supporters of Donald Trump. And I respect that. At any rate, what I wanted to say is, from a veterans report posture, there's a lot happening with regard to this administration and their, because, well, again, whether you like Donald Trump or not, he is intelligent enough, or his, the people around him are intelligent enough to have selected some very admirable and notable active duty, like an active duty general that he just, is it the Joint Chiefs of Staff? What's the brother's name? The guy's name is McWhirter. I said his name right. And then, of course, you know about Mattis and Kelly. Flynn kind of dishonored himself a little bit. But there is a lot of military guys up there, and McWhirter is the one that I'm watching the most as of recent because his narrative, biographical narrative, his narrative kind of paints him as being a person who in his military career has had the personal courage and integrity, professional integrity, I should say, to speak truth to power. And wow, is that important. I learned that when I was in the uniform. You have to be able to tell your chain of command, or in his case, to tell the suits, the civilian, you know, to say, hey, you know what? This right here, I know you don't want to hear this, and it might make things a little bit uncomfortable here, but this course of action that we're taking is not right. Or even, this is unjust. It's morally bankrupt, or I know we spend a lot of money, but this is wrong. I know somebody might get egg on their face, or we might get eggs on our face, but we need to stop. This is not right. I know we've invested a lot of time, energy, even money in this, but we need to make a hard left. We need to flank and do something different. Well, this gentleman, McWhirter, this general, that's the type of guy he is, you know, so I have a great respect, amount of respect for General Mattis. I have a tremendous amount of respect for, just said his name, Homeland Security. Can't think of his name, but he has lost a son in combat. So he just reminds me of somebody who is not going to pursue any type of military action wantonly because he personally knows the effects of combat death, his own son. Anyway, so just watching as President Trump, some people say he's overcompensating a little bit, meaning because he knows he has limited experience in certain realms, they're saying he's putting big boys around them, surrounding themselves. Hold on. Yeah. So, anyway, I'm watching. we watch as Donald Trump continues to matriculate. Hopefully he'll continue to surround himself around some individuals with who have been governed throughout their lives by military discipline and tact, the judgment that comes with military discipline and a lifetime of uniform service, and maybe some of that will actually, they'll be able to extrapolate some of the good things that come with that, and maybe some of it will bleed into some of the other people that President Trump has in his circle of influence. And anyway, we're watching as a distinguished group of military veterans take a rather pronounced leadership role in the Trump administration. Again, let's see. Gonna go to another.
Doing these concerts to raise money, but also we want to make available.
Plus, you have a shot at 20,000 people a night to tell them about the rally, and it's right. Only a few days away.
I know, Bruce.
People last night thought they were saying Bruce because it sounds Bruce.
Bruce.
Too bad the guy's name wasn't Melvin or something.
This is a song, it's called The River. This is new. This is my brother-in-law, my sister.
Wrong version, I apologize.
Johnstown Company. Well, lately there ain't been no work on account of the economy. Now all them things that seem so important, well, mister, they vanish right into the air. Now I just act like I don't remember, and Mary acts like she don't care. But I remember it's right.
Yeah, my man Bruce Springsteen, The River. A lot of people don't know this, but I spent some time right before I went to Iraq and right after I went to Iraq as a U.S. Army junior operations officer in the United States Military Liaison Office, Kingston, Jamaica. And as I close out my show, I just want to mention that I actually started producing music in Jamaica when I came back from Iraq. And they reassigned me back down to the Military Liaison Office there. And my job was to interact with members of the Jamaica Defense Force, spelled with the British defense with a C rather than an S. And I interfaced with some really exceptional men and women in uniform that made up the Jamaica Defense Force. And I was also introduced to Caribbean music, reggae music, and actually produced a young man by the name of Joel Boogie Rodney. And he was murdered in 2007 in Jamaica. Actually, we were working on his album project when he passed. And he was a young 22-year-old when he died. And he would be 32 this year. He was murdered, if I remember correctly, in the March, April, May time frame, or June maybe, I can't remember, but anyway, when you hear me do music, most people don't know that my journey, production-wise, and many of, before I ever wrote the catalog of songs that I've written, it was Joel Boogie Rodney in Jamaica, and then Lamar LaRue, who I recorded here, American young man, who I watched write and perform, and who I kind of learned how to write music behind them. So this particular group, Roots Underground, always harkens me back to my days in Jamaica. I truly enjoyed my time there. I still have lifelong bonds with members of the Jamaica Defense Force and other members of the community there. I want to play a song by Roots Underground. It's called Fire and Ice. And I ask you to listen to, I think it's the third verse. But this is a beautiful, can you turn up a little bit?
On my way home, just another lucky roll of the dice. I feel so cold sometimes that I would become a river stone, you know. But then if a river stop flow, oh no, then I lose the only love I've known. I never wanted much in my life. Your love will always suffice. And then my soul will be made from fire. When my body is made of ice.
You know I'm made from fire. You know I'm made from fire.
From fire, no.
You know I'm made from fire. You know I'm made from fire.
Sometimes I'm made of ice.
You know I'm made of ice.
Sometimes I'm made of ice.
You know I'm made of ice.
Made from fire, no, no, no.
You know I'm made of ice. You know I'm made of ice.
These days are like ta-ta times. All the leaves on the trees still, but I know some days we're so blind. I know some days we'll see too much. I know some leaves are brown, I know some leaves so green and so. Still we search and search in our souls. We don't know what most of our emotions mean. I feel so cold sometimes that I would become a river stone, ya know. But then if a river stop flow, I know. And then I lose the only love I've known. I never wanted much in my life. Your love will always suffice. And then my soul will be made from fire. When my body is made of ice.
You know I'm made from fire. You know I'm made from fire.
Made from fire, no, no, no.
You know I'm made from fire.
Fire, no, no.
You know I'm made from fire.
Sometimes I'm made of ice.
You know I'm made of ice.
Sometimes I'm made of ice.
You know I'm made of ice.
Made from fire, no, no.
You know I'm made of ice. You know I'm made of ice.
As I stand tall while I am, I'm watching this your judgment unfold. And some of these soldiers so young, some of these soldiers much too old, I know. Some of them your flowers in the garden grow. Other flowers simply they be drifting away. Say, still we search and search, we don't know. We never find the right songs to play, I know. I feel so cold sometimes that I would become a river stone, I know. But then if the river stop flow, oh, oh no. Then I lose the only love I've known. Never wanted much in my life.
Your love will always suffice.
And then my
my soul will be made from fire. When my body is made of ice.
You know I'm made from fire. You know I'm made from fire. You know I'm made from fire. You know I'm made from fire.
Sometimes I'm made of ice. You know I'm made of ice. You know I'm made of ice. You know I'm made of ice.
Okay.
From fire, no. You know I'm made of ice. From fire, no. You know I'm made of ice. When tribulation did up, you know I'm made of fire. And there's some pain and so much under there.
I might be able to make a ring.
When we're made from fire, yeah.
You know I'm made from fire.
That's when I burn light.
You know I'm made from fire.
And when tribulation did up,
you know I'm made of fire.
And then I'm lost and I'm so lonely. That's when I'm made from ice.
You know I'm made of ice.
That's when I'm made from ice.
You know I'm made of ice.
Yeah. I'm gonna put this on Twitter. Check that out. Roots Underground. Bless Kings. Yeah. Original 202 Dodge City. Son, this wraps us up for today. We look forward to seeing you in a time not too far from now. Hopefully 7 days from today. Peace and many blessings. Your host, Dodge Citizen. Thank you, Unknown Soldier. Roland Grimes in the building. My man with the plan, 50 Grand. What's your name again, sir?
Rome. Thank you.
What's Rome, that? Rome. Big Rome in the building, too. We close out. Thank you. God bless.
Oh, this is the shot. Man, tell me that ain't Malcolm.
There we go.
That's the shot. I